In this lesson, I'm going to show you how to create a workspace on your system. Now, a workspace is simply just a directory on our computer that we decide to store all of our project code. One of the key attributes separating a good developer from a great developer is organization. Now, one way that I stay organized is I decide to put all of my project code in one location on my machine. As a software developer, you're going to be working with many different projects. Now, I used to just store these projects all over my system. So I'd have some on the desktop, some in the documents, some in the downloads. Now, the problem with this is it makes it very difficult to find specific projects when you're looking for certain files. Another problem is it's hard to back up your work. So if you wanted to back up all of your code, you're going to have to dig through your system, locate all of the project files that you've stored somewhere, and make sure that you copy them all. By storing all of your project files in one location, you can easily find any code that you're looking for, because you know where it is, it'll always be in the workspace, and you can easily back it up. If you need to back up all of your code, you simply just plug in a USB disk, copy the whole workspace directory, and you have all of your code backed up. So let's create a workspace directory before continuing on and working on this project. Load up the File Explorer on your system. So on Windows, this is the File Explorer, and head over to the Home directory. Now, I always create my workspace directory in the Home directory. I'll tell you why later. So in the Home directory, right-click and click New Folder. We're going to call the folder Workspace. Now, we're going to be using this Workspace folder a lot because it's going to have all of our source code in. So let's create a shortcut up here in the quick access so we can get to it easily later on in the course. All right, so now we have our workspace directory. Let's create a folder inside that for the project we're going to be working on. So go into the workspace directory, and the project we're going to be working on is going to be called the Profiles REST API. So create a new folder inside the workspace called the Profiles REST API. Now, I recommend not using spaces or capital letters when you create the names of your projects. The reason for that is we're going to be using the Git bash to navigate into our directory, and it makes it a lot easier to do that if there's no spaces in the names. So my personal preference is to just avoid using spaces in the names in general. All right, so now that we've created our project directory, I'm going to show you how to open that project directory in Atom Editor. So Atom is a text editor that we installed in the previous videos of this course. Now, if you haven't already installed it, I recommend going back to the previous videos and getting that installed because we're going to be using it a lot during this course. All right, so let's load up Atom, click on Start, search for Atom, and load up the Atom desktop app. When Atom loads, it's going to show you a welcome screen like this if you haven't loaded it before. So this is just telling you some information about Atom. We can close these tabs off for now. And we're going to load up our project folder in Atom. So the way that you do that is you click on File, and you click Add Project Folder. From the Open Folder menu, select the workspace and click on the Profiles REST API folder and click Select Folder. Now, the nice thing about this is you can open up multiple different projects at the same time. So if you're working on multiple different things or maybe related projects, you can open them all up here in the Atom editor, and you can navigate them using the tree view. You can also create new files, new folders, you can rename files. You can basically do everything that you can do in the File Explorer in Atom. And that makes it really easy to work with because you can work with everything all in one place. Okay, so now that you know how to open up the project folder in Atom, I'm going to show you how to navigate to the project folder using the Git bash. Now, if you're on Mac or Linux, you can just use the terminal for this. Because we're on Windows, we're going to use the tool called the Git bash. So if you click Start and you just search for bash or Git bash, you load this up. This is a tool that we installed earlier when we installed Git on our system. Now, it basically is a replacement for the command prompt window, which you may be familiar with, but it gives you a lot of the Linux command line tools that we're going to need to use in this course. It also looks a lot better and it's a lot easier to work with Git projects using the Git bash compared to the command prompt. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to navigate to our project folder using the Git bash. The way that you do it is you use a command called the change directory command, and it's abbreviated to CD. It stands for change directory. So we can just type ls here to list all of the folders and files in the current location. So you can see here, we have the workspace directory. That's the workspace directory that we created earlier. Now, the reason we created it in the home folder is because whenever you load up the Git bash or the command prompt, or if you're on Mac or Linux, the terminal, it automatically defaults to the home directory. That's what this little squiggly line here represents. That represents the home directory. So having created our workspace in the home directory, it makes it really easy to work with the terminal because you don't have to go to fiddly paths like locations on the system, because when you first load it up, it automatically defaults to the home directory. So we're gonna use the CD command to change into the workspace. You simply do that by typing CD and then workspace and hit enter. And now you can see that we're in the squiggly line or the home directory /workspace. Now let's type ls and we can see all of the projects in our workspace. So far we only have our profiles REST API. So use the CD command again to move into the profiles REST API. And here's a hint. If you start typing the first few letters of a directory name and then you hit the tab key, it will auto-complete based on the names of the directories that are available in the current location. So because we have a directory that starts with profiles, it auto-completed it to profiles REST API. That'll save you a lot of typing later on as we go through the course. Okay, so after typing CD profiles REST API, hit enter, and now we are in the profiles REST API location. Okay, so that's how you navigate to it. Now, let's just say you wanted to navigate back to the previous location. Well, you do that, type in CD dot dot. That stands for change directory into the parent directory of the current location. So if you type CD dot dot, it'll take you back to the workspace. You type CD profiles again, profiles REST API, it'll take you back there. Okay, so that's how you create a workspace, open your project up in Atom, and navigate to your project using the Git bash or the terminal. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you found it useful, and I'll see you in the next lesson.